Look at this crackhead. Crackhead.
Yeah.
Say no.
I can't. I can't. Sorry, I'm an urban DC person, so certain things aren't gonna leave my system. Chicken wings with mambo sauce, girls with a gigantic waist and hip ratio, and records. And Rock Creek fruit punch soda.
Cap mother off and brown in the house.
Yo,
look at that. I gotta make a rap face. Is that what I gotta say?
I gotta make rap hands. Rap hands.
Let's go. That's right. That's right. Rap hands all day.
You need a do-rag on.
Nah. I was raised right.
taping me right now with a drink in my hand with Sprague. Pink Space, everybody. Kept running the house.
What are we listening to right now?
Marvin Gaye joints. Shout out to Marvin Gaye, one of the greatest ever in life. Tribute to Marvin, you know what I mean? MPG tribute. Go on official Kev Brown, check it out right now. Go on SoundCloud, and check it out.
How do you feel about love?
Love is misery.
And the guitar and sing. He went to Berkeley for harmony. You ever heard of this? Harmony therapy.
No.
You studying harmonies. Like you're studying the structure of music. Like
pleasure talking with you. We wish you all the best.
Look, I know that nigger is a bad idiom, and I get it. I understand what it represents, and I understand the beauty of black people, of how we've taken so much negative stuff and just mentally made it better. Example one, could you imagine the look on a white person's face when you saw a conversation of two black men and they were referencing something as bad, but he could tell by their connotation and their smiles that it was actually good? We've had a history of that. The moment something was good in hip-hop, what did we call it? We called it ill. We called it dope. And when I say nigga, that means something has brought me an illicit amount of joy, or I'm confused at the highest level. So if you're in public and you hear Iron go, yeah. Something happened.
Right.
Something happened.
And I have the right lady, and the right consciousness, and a good girl. Girl who don't fool around too much and all that stuff.
Hundreds of thousands of screaming fans out there. How do you feel?
Hot.
I guess so, with all the lights.
No. It's a wonderful feeling. I don't know. It's the personal satisfaction is. It's one of the few things that I think give you peace of mind in this business. When the hard things and the hardships and the panics and the button pushes and the screamers in every body of this type, and you sort it all, sit back.
I put this online a couple of times, and Kev has agreed to it online, but if I have video documentation of it, it's signed and sealed. DJ Iron, Kev Brown, the district, disc belt like disc, it's gonna be one song per disc. The District of Columbia, EP. We're doing it. It's gonna scare the shit out of you. And you know what? Go buy adult Pampers.
Wow.
You're gonna piss yourself.
Depends.
You're gonna piss yourself. DJ Iron, Kev Brown, yo. This trick of America. It's happening. It's happening.
Yo. Y'all know who this is right here? Y'all know who this is, man?
You know who that is?
Whatever.
My God.
People talk about Stretch and Bobbito and like Funk Flex and all that, but like this is DC area. This is that Stretch Bob. Yo, DJ Iron and Super Funk Regulator CeeLo, Saturday nights.
Absolutely.
Staying up late, you had your tape deck. I still got tapes. First place I ever heard Wu-Tang. You know what I mean?
Hold on, but we gotta talk about this guy. Now look. No, stop. Because you know what? DC, in all honesty, everybody knew to come here to find people to play in their band. Go-Go,
yeah.
It's a band.
Mad talented artist, though.
Every artist knew to come to DC to get a band member. Kev Brown was the first person, aside from Chucky Thompson, to be able to take drum machine stuff and take it somewhere. He took it to Philly. Chucky took it to Bad Boy. I mean, he's an architect.
Jazzy Jeff.
He took it to Jazzy Jeff. It's architect. So you got two architects here. All right.
He leaving himself out.
No, I'm not. I'm an architect. I'm an architect. No. I'm an
Yo,
architect.
I was listening to DJ Iron before I was making beats. You know what I mean? Like, it was beats wasn't even
Yo,
cracking. I was just listening to music.
I was listening to Kev Brown and realized I really wasn't making beats. How about that?
You selected few in the midst of that. Life keeps forming in the loop with that fuck shit. Living paycheck to paycheck, living life like the needle laying in that haystack. Up every night with no rest, bitch, I'm on a quest to be the best. It ain't easy, rap, it can be real speedy, but shit, I can get real greedy. I'm just trying to change the scenery, I need to be somewhere over.
Masses, but I have a special God who looks over me. Who
is the same God that the people worship institutionally, but I feel I have a special link. Anyone can have a special link if they will assert themselves.